Shopping for a new hard drive can be a little confusing for the inexperienced. The good news is, it can be simplified. Hard drive brands suffer the same ignorant opinions that car manufacturers get all the time. Depending on who you ask will depend on which brand is the best.
My brother's cousin bought a Dodge 42 years ago and hadn't had one problem. I'm born, bred, Dodge fed.
Well, you'll always get a story or a reason behind everyone's decision for the brand of hard drive. They might have had a few that failed over the years, or they might have had a few that's lasted many, many years. For one reason or another, some brand has either won their loyalty or gained their hatred. That's the worst part, though. You never really know what model of drives they had or how old they were. Were they IDE drives? Were they SATA drives? 2.5-inch or 3.5-inch? There's so many variables to the success or failure rate of a drive, it's hard to know what to believe. So let's simplify things just a little bit. And to start things off, we have to make sure that you're actually in the right place. So for this video, we're going to assume that you're looking for a SATA drive, and you need it for a basic operating system, or you need it just to store data only. So if your drive has connections that look similar to this, then you might have something called an IDE drive. This is a really old technology, and that really means that this video is not going to be relevant to your situation. However, if you have a SATA drive, and it looks a little bit like this, then you should be good. Next up, what do you want your drive to be used for? Mostly, people only buy standard platter drives or hard drives for storage. If you're looking for a fast option to install an operating system on, then you might be looking for something called an SSD, or a solid state drive. If you don't need a super fast speed or anything like that and you're just looking for storage, then we can continue. Part of simplifying your experience, we'll have to narrow down your options. This video is going to use information from a study that included almost 35,000 hard drives. In this study, they really only focused on a few big brands. This is mainly because of the level of market saturation for those major brands, and when it really comes down to it, the big brands either have their hands in a lot of the smaller companies, or they just flat out own them. So I'm going to go ahead and stick with this theme, because, well, it makes sense. Even though one of them are still mostly owned by the other. These brands are going to be Seagate, Western Digital, and HGST, formerly known as Hitachi. HGST is actually a Western Digital company now, but whatever. Narrowing the brands down to the big name players like this will allow us to easily look at the raw numbers and make an educated decision. Because keeping your data safe is usually the most important, we're going to look at the annual failure rate, or the chance the drive has to die within a 12-month period. And dead last, Seagate comes up with an 8-9% failure rate. It doesn't seem very high, but if you lose an entire library of music or pictures or movies, you might think a little bit differently. Western Digital, which happens to be my favorite, comes in second place with an annual failure rate of 3%. It's a pretty big jump. And first place, reigning champ, HGST. While still a Western Digital at heart, HGST has an annual failure rate of only 1%. That's pretty phenomenal. Now, all three of these brands offer similar performances, or at least options, but we're going to compare them to price, and you're going to see how you might stray just a little bit. For example, the performance line can have a difference of over $100 per 4 TB hard drive. You could grab a Seagate for around $160, while the same Western Digital drive might cost you $230. And for similar performance, you can get an HGST drive for about $300. You pay for quality, hands down. Now you can see why Western Digital is my favorite. To me, it's still a great, reliable brand, and it has a decent price. Well, that and I actually lost some data to a Seagate before, but whatever. That brings me to my next point, backups. Now you can stew over how much you want to spend and what your needs are, but at the end of the day, every single hard drive will always fail at some point. It's only a matter of time. Be it 11 months or 11 years, it will fail. Anything mechanical in nature, like a hard drive, is going to have an expiration date. And that's why it's always good to keep your valuable data backed up. You can watch my video here to see the methods on how you can do this. Trust me when I say this, if you have anything valuable, anything at all, you need to back it up. Well, I hope this video helped you out. If you like it, please click like below and don't forget to subscribe.